Forward, side, side. Feel free to join in if anyone's wanting to, you know, getting restless.
Jumps to avoid, or is it as long as the technique's good for the jump, it's okay to...
I think the best answer she gave you is that that is to be relevant, if it's relevant to benefit. Because I have a real issue with doing the frog jump and the duck walk and all that kind of thing, because all it does is destroy you. That's all it does. And it's not relevant to having at all doing that kind of walk.
Yeah.
So that's, I think, when you're in the gym or when you're doing physical exercise, make sure that the movement matches what you do on a court. There's no need to go to the extreme to try and improve the movement that you have to do.
I agree, so specificity, the same thing. You can break down that one particular jump and make it harder within specific demands, but if it's something you're not going to practice on, you support that there is a huge amount of relevance. So down, And then you can add in iron ball, but I'd say to you, left, right. So you turn left, then right, and on the way back I pass the ball. So he's got to actually have the arms up over here, which is what they think you're going to be landing. I don't know how you'd adapt that, but have a think. And they also then do it, so if you can do similar to before with the lunge, just jump, say, forwards or... Another movement they do a lot of is just kind of this, sorry, one, two, three, pass, and a lot of them, as I've just heard with you, they'll come over here and they'll lift this leg up and come back. So you're actually accelerating from here and you're wanting to be shifting your weight. So you're driving off that inside leg. So even if you do lift up the foot, can I get you to come and try and sort of be really interesting because I know
you're warmed up.
Enjoying it?
Well, no, I'm good. I mean, badminton's a cat, but sidestepping, you're just doing what I did there. So fast feet to start. And then go one way, and then come back again, and then the other way. So this time what I want you to do is when you're coming back, I want you to put your hand on your inside leg.
Inside?
Yeah. Okay. So you're here, come over here, hand on inside leg, and just show them what happens. See the weight shift? So they're not thinking that they have to shift their weight, but they're actually, by putting their hand down here, the weight's gone from here to there. Whether you lift the foot or not, I don't think is as relevant, but it's just trying to actually get that kind of process of, you just don't want to be, you did something about here, and then coming, that's much more risky than being able to actually have the weight over this leg. I'd love to know how you adapt that for that.
We almost couldn't.